I'd like to start by saying a welcome, because that's why we're here. That's one reason why we're here. I want to do a welcome that we use. I live in a community called Canticle Farm in Oakland, California, and we have a practice at our Sunday morning liturgy of welcoming. The Zen priest Pema Chodron says that if I can keep my heart open that much, just that much, wider today than I could do yesterday, then I'm on the path of the spiritual warrior. And so this welcome, I'm going to invite you as I go through it to open your heart and keep it open. And if you feel it constricting at any point, just notice that. And use it as a spiritual practice, because that's why we're here. That's one of the main reasons we're here, is to welcome every single man that's in this room and coming. The way this works is after I state who we're welcoming, I'm going to say, we say, and then you say, welcome. So I say, we say,
welcome.
And have that welcome come up from your gut. Just feel your gut. Feel that welcome down in there in the bottom of your gut come up through. We say,
welcome.
Good. I would like to welcome people on all parts of the continuum of sexual identity and expression, gay, bisexual, heterosexual, transgender, queer folks, the sexually active and the celibate, and everyone for whom those labels do not apply. We say,
welcome.
People of African descent, of Asian descent, of European descent, of First Nations descent in this land and abroad, and people of mixed and multiple descents, and all of the languages spoken here, we say,
welcome.
Your bodies and bodies of all abilities and challenges, those living with a chronic medical condition, visible or invisible, we say,
welcome.
People who identify as activists and those who don't, mystics, believers, seekers of all kinds, people of all ages, those who support you to be here, we say,
welcome.
Your emotions, joy, fear, grief, contentment, disappointment, surprise, and all else that flows through you, we say,
welcome.
Your families, genetic and otherwise, those dear to us who have died, our ancestors and the future ones, welcome to the ancestors who lived in this land, in this place where these buildings are now. I especially want to mention the Santa Ana Pueblo. We honor you through this work we are undertaking, and we say,
welcome.
And at this point, I also want to welcome any man who has ever been affected by abortion, because I'm bringing this up. This isn't our normal part of our normal welcome, but because of something that's going on in my own family, every man who has ever been affected by abortion, who has ever walked that path with a woman that you care for, we say,
welcome.
All beings that inhabit this earth, human or otherwise, the two-legged, the four-legged, winged, finned, and those that walk, fly, crawl, above the ground and below, in air and water, we say,
welcome.
And at this point, I normally say my own personal welcome, and I want to welcome any man, any person who identifies as a person of color, who is in this room, in this circle, to come to me in any way that works for you. If my role in this group as a leader or facilitator triggers pain in you, either pain from personal experience or ancestral pain, I see it as my role at this particular place, in this society, in this culture, at this particular time in history, as a white, male, straight, middle-class man, to create a space where that trauma can come out and I can witness it, and that we can receive the grace to grieve it appropriately. Thank you.